Hi, 8th class. We have completed this chapter, chapter 5, Social Justice and the Marginalized. Now, in this video, we will do the exercise and question answer of this chapter. So, first of all, let we discuss the MCQs there is a given. The first one is, which of these term does not mean marginalization? Do you know very well about the marginalization? Marginalization describes both a process and a condition that prevents individuals or groups from full participation in social, economic and political life. Do you know now? Yes. Means it is given the three options: isolation, seclusion and inclusion. So which one is correct? Seclusion and inclusion also denotes the marginalization. The one isolation is not mean marginalization. So A option is there. You will tick the one option is there. Now the second one, which of the following is not a marginalized group? Options are there: scheduled caste and tribes, second one Muslims, and third one upper castes. So scheduled caste and tribes and Muslims also come in the category of marginalized group, but upper caste is not a marginalized group. So you will take the C option. Now the next one, which of the following groups is now called Dalits? Which one, students? The scheduled tribes, scheduled caste or religious minority? The official name given in India, the lowest caste considered Dalit, and this one is scheduled caste. Got it? Now the fourth one, a minority is a community marginalized on the basis of religion, language, both of these. So answer is there, both of these. Now the next one, which commissions was set up to make recommendation for the uplifting of social and educationally backward groups? So this one is Mandal Commission. Okay, now fill in the blanks also given here. The first one, the dash groups are denied access to various rights, opportunity and resources that are available to other groups. So marginalized groups. Now the second one, dash percentage of seats are reserved for other backward classes in education and government job. So 27%. Now the next one, the dash act lists action that are considered crime against SCs and STs. So Prevention of Atrocities Act. Now the next one, all citizens of India have the right to conserve their distinct language, custom or culture. Here is a, you will write custom. Now the next one, Dalit can invoke a, which article if they feel that they have been treated badly by some individual or community or even by the government? So Article 17. Now, true or false statements are also given here. You have to do yourself. First of all, you will read the chapter attentively, then you can solve very easily. Got it? Now the D part also given here. Explain the following term in one or two sentences. First one is given marginalization, then marginalized groups. C1 scheduled caste, D scheduled tribes, and minorities. Okay, so you will write all these terms in your fair notebook. You will write attentively and carefully. Now answers are there. The first one is marginalization is a social phenomenon by which a particular group or class of people is accorded less importance and pushed to be the margin. Got it? And now the next B, marginalized groups. Marginalized groups can always be identified by members of a dominant society and will face irrevocable discrimination. Clear, everyone? Now the C, scheduled caste. Scheduled caste, the official name given in India to the lowest caste. Lowest caste kaun hai wo? Dalit. Okay, Dalit ka official name given by our constitution, scheduled caste. Considered to be a section of people in Hindu society who are not from the four major varnas. Or four major varnas kaun si thi wo? Brahmans, Kshatriya, these were, okay, Shudras. And the next one is D, scheduled tribes. So scheduled tribes as a, such as a tribes or tribal communities or groups who lived in tribal area. Okay, note down. Now the next question, the E part, answer the following. First question is there. What is marginalization and what are its effects on the marginalized groups? So answer is there. Sorry, I forgot one term also there, minorities. Okay, minorities ke baad hum question first karenge. So minorities, let me write. So answer is there, minority. Minority means the smaller number or part of a group less than half. Okay. Now the first question again. What is marginalization and what are its effect on the marginalized groups? So answer is there. Marginalization describes both a process and a condition that prevents individuals or groups from full participation in social, economic and political life. Marginalization can impact of wide range of groups on the basis of age, gender, language and disability, etc. Got it? Effects on marginalization. The marginalized groups are denied access to various rights, opportunities and resources that are available to other groups. They suffer at the hands of more powerful and dominant section of society. Here is the written dominant. Okay, and is there. Dominant. Got it? Note down attentively. Now the next question is there. How have the following groups been marginalized in India? How? First one is Dalit, B Adivasis and C one religious minorities. So answer is there. First one is Dalit. The marginalization of Dalit influences all sphere of their life. It violates their basic human rights such as civil, political, social, economic and cultural rights. Got it? And the second one, Adivasis. They are socially and economically backward and less than, here is a given, and less than, because reflections there, less than inclined towards change. They lead a life of isolation. They lead a life of isolation due to lack of education facilities. They are educationally backward. Okay. Now the C one, religious minorities. Religious minorities is a religion held by a minority of a population of a country. It may be subject or stigma discrimination. Okay, clear? Now the next question is there. The third one is there. How does the constitution safeguard the rights of the scheduled caste and tribes? Okay, there is a mentioned constitution safeguard. So answer is there. Okay, third question. Answer. Constitutional provision for safeguard the interest of scheduled caste and the scheduled tribes are Article 15. It prohibits any discrimination on the basis of religion, caste, creed, gender or place of birth. Here is a written place of birth. Okay, the next one, Article 16. It guarantees equality. Okay, equality of opportunity for all citizens in matter of employment under the central and state government. Article 17, in it, untouchability has been abolished and has been declared as a punishable offense. Article 46, it provides that state should take care of the education and economic interest of the weaker section of the people. Okay. Now the next question, fifth question is there, sorry, fourth one. What efforts have been made by the government to improve the condition of the scheduled caste and tribes? So answer is there. The government makes specific law and policies for the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes for improve their condition. These are reservation law, political participation, provide coaching and training facility, provide free and subsidized hostels for SC and ST, provide scholarship for higher education, provide vocational training, provide free textbooks. Okay, so note down. Now the next question. Now the fifth one question is there. describe the brief two law passes by the government to safeguard interest of scheduled caste and interest of scheduled tribes. There is no need to do that questions. In previous questions we have already done. And now the sixth question is there. How does the constitution help the minorities maintaining their language and culture? So you will write the answer. The constitution provide provision to help the minorities in maintaining their language and culture are Article 29.1 lays down that all citizens of India have right to conserve their distinct language, script or culture. Okay. And Article 30 lays down that all religious and linguistic minorities have a right to set up educational institution of their choice. Note down. The next one is, there are the some creative analysis and evaluation based questions. Which fundamental rights can the Dalit or Adivasis invoke to get equality and social justice? And the second one, the which fundamental right can the minorities invoke to get social justice? So students, these both questions you have to do yourself. Okay, first of all, in page number 42 given, how the fundamental rights help the Dalit. You will read this paragraph carefully and then you will give the answer yourself. Is that clear? There is also given, the constitutional grants fundamental rights to all Indian equally. Dalits can invoke or draw on a fundamental rights in two ways. Okay, two ways. How? By insisting of their fundamental rights, they can force the government to recognize the injustice done them. In which article? Article 15. You will mention in Article 15. They will apply. Okay. The constitution which states that no citizen of India shall be discriminated against on the basis of religion, race, caste, sex or place of the birth. You will write yourself. And the second one also given here. So Adivasis also there is a given. Okay, one Minister of Tribal Affairs was set up in 1992. This one act, and act one again. Welfare scheme also given, or act also again. Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribes Act passed by 1989 seeks to undo the historical injustice to forest dwelling population. Got it? Act 1 also given here. Forest Dweller Act 2006. And the next second question, what is given here? Ki minority, which fundamental right can the minority involved to get the social justice answer? You will write from that side. Okay, right to freedom of religion and cultural and educational rights have the distinct cultural and religious groups. Which act you will mention? Right to freedom of religion and cultural and educational rights. Okay. You will read this paragraph carefully. Article also given here, 29 first and Article 29 in part second, Article 30. Okay, khud try kijiye. Now, I think our chapter is completed. We will start our next chapter in next video.